Hey everybody, welcome to the shop at Jet City Turbines, where we build, we fix, and we talk about jet engines. Now if you want to support the channel, you can get one of these at Redbubble. Just look for Jet City Turbines. We're working on getting a local, like in-town producer of these things, so I'll let you know when that happens. But for now, I got a question yesterday that was I thought it was overly simplistic, or what did I think? I dismissed it, but I shouldn't have. So we're going to deal with it today. The question was, hi there, is the shaft of high pressure and low connected together? Okay, no, of course not, if you've watched any of my videos. But I said, you're not making sense. The high pressure and low pressure are two separate systems. Okay, hang on. Then he said, what I mean is the cold and hot section on the same shaft or not. And again, that was kind of like, you're asking me to tell you how to tie your shoes kind of thing. And he said, and connected together. So I realized that I've never backed up that far before. Helps to think about what is a compressor and what is a turbine. Because a jet engine is a compressor, combustors, turbine, and nozzle. What is a compressor? Well, you could call it a super high performance compressor, because it, without reducing the velocity of the air a whole lot as the airplane is traveling through the air, it rapidly compresses the air and delivers it to the combustors. Now, that takes a huge amount of power to compress 150,000 cubic feet of air per second. Takes a lot. So you need a power source for that. And the power comes from the burning of the fuel. The jet engines burn a ton, not an actual ton, but oftentimes more, but a great amount of fuel, because you need a great amount of energy to do the two things that the combustion energy does. One of them is supply power. 2/3 of the power in the fuel goes to compressing the air, and 1/3 gets squirted out the back through the propelling nozzle to make it a jet engine. A jet engine, like an octopus or a squid, jets the water out the back and it goes forward. So I said 2/3 of the power. 2/3 of the power in the fuel being burnt gets used to turn the compressor, because it takes a lot of horsepower to turn that compressor. Well, how do you turn it? A turbine. A turbine is something that is turned by a stream of gases, or the wind, or flowing water, but it's a fluid. A fluid flowing through a turbine causes it to turn, like a windmill, like a pinwheel, like a wind turbine, like a turbine, and that causes the shaft to rotate with mechanical power. So that rotating shaft is connected to the compressor and drives it. This is the Arenda turbine. So it extracts about 20,000 horsepower, 20,000 horsepower from the exhaust gases to turn the compressor. This is the compressor here. It's facing down. There's the intake. This is the outlet. There's another one right there. Those are the combustors. That's the jet propelling nozzle. If you can't see it, you've seen it lots in this shot here. This shot. Oh no, we don't include any symbols in our videos. I'd like to show you the connectors, or the ways that it's connected together. So you've seen the big splines that go into here on the previous videos on the Arenda. We've seen the spline on the compressor and the turbine of the J79. And what holds it together? What holds those two things together? Why don't they just fly apart? Hang on a second. All right, let's see. For the J79, this is technically a bolt. There's a whole video devoted to this. It comes out of the turbine. Yes, it goes out. When the engine is face down on the stand, it screws clockwise out of the turbine with a fine thread and into the compressor with a coarse thread. So it draws the two together. And when they make contact, this ratcheting mechanism around the edge, you see that, these teeth? They allow it to travel in one direction and they're like a ratchet. They lock it in place until you squeeze them all back in with a special tool called the pogo stick. Anyway, so this holds the turbine to the compressor. That's what this is. Now this is a bolt. It's exactly the same thing, exactly as this, only different. This is the arenda, what they call it, the tension member. It's the main tensile coupling. It's got a right-hand thread on both ends. So let's see, if it's a right-hand thread on both ends, it could spin inside the engine and come loose, but it can't because it's locked in place by both a circlip and these shoulders. It's spun in all the way to the turbine, so it can't turn anymore. And then the compressor is turned until it locks in this thing. And there's a rotational spline that you saw that transmits the rotational force. What this thing does is hold those two things together. That's what holds it together. So the AI-25, this is the LP shaft. The discs bolt onto here. And the low pressure turbine shaft goes through the center of the HP, the high pressure turbine shaft. The two systems are not connected, but this is connected to the low pressure compressor by, this is the drive tube, drive shaft. It's not a shaft, it's a tube. Can you see that through there? And so this goes into there very nicely. This transmits the torque, but what holds it together? What holds it together? It's hollow so that this can fit through there. This is the turbine to compressor, low pressure turbine to low pressure compressor bolt. Holds it together. Its only function is to pull. It works in tension. It holds the two parts together. So you've got the transmission of the torque by the splines and the transmission of the holding of the spline together by the tension on the bolt. We have one more engine to look at. That is the T58. Now this is the curvic coupling. You see that? It's a curvic coupling. It transmits torque to the turbine discs and the shaft tapers down to this, which transmits the torque of the turbines into the compressor. I don't have the compressor barrel or shaft or assembly here, but I do have what holds it together. This is the turbine to compressor coupling bolt. Again, it's a bolt. Goes through here. That threads into the back of the compressor shaft assembly, whatever you want to call it, drum. And the turbine discs bolt onto here, and there's a nut that holds it on that we tighten up there. And so this thing works in tension. This transmits the torque. So let's just see. We have four pieces that are exactly the same here. This is exactly the same as that. Exactly the same as that. Wait, it goes this way. Exactly the same as this. You see? Like I always say about the engines, they're exactly the same and they're all different. Tension, 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 and tension. Super cool. Thanks for watching.